Hi guys, my name is Shiraz Belolia and I'm an F-class shooter on the US F-class Open Rifle Team. I've been shooting competitively for many, many years. I've shot in 3 world championships, former captain of the US F-class team, and won several national championships as well. Today we're going to talk about firefoaming in its most basic terms. So firefoaming in its most basic terms means that you're going to take a round and fire it in the chamber that you wish the round to be firefoamed to. It's going to expand this case when we fire it to the chamber that it's in. So when you load this and you fire this, when it comes out, this case is firefoamed to that chamber. And so if you put this in another rifle that was chambered for somebody else, it may not fit, or if it fits, it may be too loose, or it may not have the accuracy. So for consistency, we need a good firefoaming round or case. Wildcatters use it for foaming their brass to a specific size that they want. In this case, this particular chamber, this is a different chamber than this. This is a 300 WSM that I shoot in matches. This is a 284 Shiraz. It's a 284 case that is blown out a little bit more so that I can put more powder in it. You know, F-open shooters are hot rodders basically. On your first firing, it's imperative that you don't load your normal loads that you put in. And say you're firefoaming a 284, straight 284, you're not doing anything to it, you're not blowing out the case like I am. You're just going to firefoam it for foaming to your chamber. It is imperative that you do not use the load that you normally use for loading your rounds in a match. And the reason for that is when you firefoam this, a brand new case, it has to expand more than normal. It's not expanding through from your fired round. It's expanding from a Sammy Spec factory round case. And so there's a lot of pressure going on. So in order to save life on the brass, you should cut it down maybe 10-15% of your charge, of your normal charge, for firefoaming. And then work your way back up on the second and third loading to your normal charges. Because there's a lot of stuff happening when you fire that. You know, the case may expand more. You know, the factory case may be 7,000-8,000 short on the headspace for Sammy Spec. The diameter of the case itself might be, you know, many thousands smaller than what your normal case will be. So, having said that, let's talk about this guy right here a little bit. It's actually a bench rest railgun. I had one made about 15 years ago I don't shoot bench rest, but for testing rounds. It's because there's a return to battery so that my point of aim would always be the same, so it's easy for testing, but I didn't quite enjoy doing that. I do test now the way I shoot, which is laying on the ground prone, just with my rest, and I've become good at that, and that's your real life condition. So that's how I test. So this thing I had built by a fellow by the name of Mac McCloskey, a really good machinist. He lived in the state of Washington. Unfortunately, a year after he built this, he passed away. It's very intricate. It's really well made. It was just sitting around, so I figured, you know, I need to fire foam a whole bunch of brass, and normally when I fire foam at the range, I used to go with my fire foam barrel. I don't use my match barrels for fire foaming. I have a identically chambered with the same reamer, a barrel that I use specifically for fire foaming, and it's, you know, you don't have to clean it, you just shoot through it, and you don't have to worry about life of the barrel, etc. When I go to the range, normally it would take me, you know, I'd shoot 40 rounds, the barrel would get overheated. You don't want to go too far because then, you know, the chamber starts to expand as the barrel gets too hot. So then you blow cold air and cool the barrel down, and it was a tedious process. It would take me, I could shoot maybe 150 rounds in a few hours, and it would just be very tedious. I'd have to stop and go. So what this is a barrel cooler that is gonna keep the barrel cool so that I can continuously fire foam. I've got 500 rounds right now to do this on this round, which is a 284 Shiraz. And it's just, you know, I'm just gonna fire foam 500 rounds in one sitting. I'll probably be done in like 30 minutes or so, because it's just a matter of loading and shooting. So cold water is gonna go in through here and circulate through this and go out this way. So there's continuous flow of cold water. It doesn't need to be a lot of water, just enough to keep the barrel cool, so that the barrel is always going to remain cool. And this will go back to the sink or wherever I want it. And in this jig here, I had a shock put in as well, so I can, you know, it's not gonna be a big impact. And I don't even have to put a scope on this thing. I just make sure that it's gonna hit a berm, and that's all there is to it. So yeah, that's the idea of a barrel cooler thing. This is nice looking. It looks like a space age Gatling gun or something. You don't have to have something this fancy. You could make a simple roller base that put a couple shots on it and get away with that. I've known guys that have done that. And that's all there is to it. So we're gonna take this puppy out to the range and let's go shoot. Alrighty, so we're here at the range right now, and I've got everything set up. I've got the water lines running. This is the in, the red ones are out, and it's a trickle. It doesn't need to be a very heavy flow of water. So the way this is set up is it's hitting a berm at about 500-600 yards, and it's I don't need a scope. I looked through the, I took this out and looked through here to see where the barrel was aiming, and I was right there. So I'm gonna load with my right hand and trigger with the left hand, and we'll fire foam these two boxes of ammunition. There's about 600 rounds or so. Let's go. And the cases are cool to the touch because of the barrel being cooled with this water. It's everything is cool. There's no heat anywhere. You can see the impact on that little broom over there. A little bit of smoke as the bullet hits the broom. So even after 250 rounds through this barrel, this is cool to the touch. The case, this case just came off from the thing. They're all cool, there's no problems, and there's 250 rounds without any issues. My fingers hurt from pulling the trigger, but the barrel's cool. So that's the infeed, and this is the water coming out. It's just a trickle, and it's not even warm or anything. It's the same temperature. And it goes through this. You don't need much water to keep that that barrel cool. So that's how simple it is. And now it's gonna stop, and I'm gonna drain the other end into a bucket so that there's no leaks anywhere, and I can put this away. I hope you enjoyed this video. It's an easy way to fire foam glass and not have to worry about cooling the barrel in between 30 rounds or so.
I was able to do 250 rounds in a matter of 15-20 minutes. And just the setup took longer than making sure that this was hitting the berm and not ricocheting off the ground. So thank you for watching this video.